Hello, YouTube. I want to take a look at a program called RexPaint, which I stumbled onto recently on itch.io. And so RexPaint is a text mode painting program, in essence, but it's novel in the way that it works. I know a thing or two about text mode. And so I thought I would review this. So one of the things I like about it is it's more like a traditional paint program. You can use the keyboard to do things once you're in focus here. But if you look at what's happening with the keyboard, it's changing the character. So this is interesting in that it's a mouse and keyboard driven kind of affair versus strictly keyboard only. The other thing that's neat about it is it's 256 colors at your immediate disposal here. So if I pick this, let's see if I can. I don't remember how I don't know how to use this yet. But anyway, the idea is that you have a font set, a palette, and then a bunch of tools. And then you have more traditional painting stuff with text mode. The neat thing about this is that there's lots of different font sets. And I'll just show you a few of them. So this is the code page 340 or 437 one that comes with it. And then there are others, which I believe I've just broken the program. And I had to custom add these in for the public domain offerings that were available on their website. So let me go through it this way. There's one that doesn't fit on the screen, this 18 by 18. 8x8 is going to look good. This would be great for doing some good stuff. 10x10. Then you can see there's other fonts that other people have used. So I'm going to get rid of back. And now as I paint, you can see that's not a traditional character, nor is that. This is kind of like a pixel. And you can see a bunch of different little characters here, which is pretty awesome. And you can see like people have made teletext fonts in here, as well as their own custom things, right? So it's really a neat little tool, and I'm kind of excited about using it. For the obvious reason is it lets me exploit a little bit more about text mode. And I could create my own fonts even to do this. The other thing about this program is that the Rex format is very, very small. So there are readers and SDK kind of things for programming. And I thought, well, it would be kind of neat to be able to do 256 colors in console, as well as a separate font of my own devising. So, I'm not quite sure how the font renders, but I thought it was definitely a neat experiment. And I wanted to show this because I was very inspired for one simple idea I'll show you in a second. And I think I've got my font map all screwed up here. Let me go back to the default. Okay, let's use this 16 by 16 one. Let's create a new image. You also have layers. Okay, so there's an options screen, and you can change the width and the height. And as you can see below, it says the width of the canvas view area in cells, which in turn determines the application's width, plus 18 cells for the sidebar. The minimum value is 42 and does not take effect until RexPaint is restarted. So I'm going to change this to 80, and I'm going to change this. I'm going to leave that. Actually, I'm going to change that to 40 because that. Okay, I can't do smaller than 42. Minimum value is 60 for width, for height. Okay, so I'm going to change it to that, and then I'm going to restart the program. So I'm going to close that, do that. Yep, that's fine, and I'm going to reopen the program here. Okay, so now if I look in the options, it did not take. Why not? 80, enter. How do you until RexPaint is restarted? Okay. Why is it not saving that? Is there an apply button? or anything like that. I wonder if my image or my file for the RexPaint INI or config is writable. Check version, SPF cap. I don't know what any of this stuff is. Shift interval, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so I can't change this. And then if you press the question mark, you can see the hotkeys. So there's quite a lot of little things that you can do just with it as it is. So I'm going to hit exit now and try this again. I didn't hit exit. I just closed it last time. So maybe if I hit the exit button, it will. No, it looks like it's still 60 by 60. Okay, so let me find my RexPaint file. And let me do this in another screen real quick just to make sure I'm not exposing any sensitive information. Because I work from home and I don't want to do that. So let me just see what I can see here, because I think I opened it up. Yeah, so this is okay. So that's my fonts config. Sorry, I'll show you in a moment what I'm doing. So let's open the manual real quick. And I'll make this full screen and I'll show you guys what I'm doing here. So what I've done is I've tried to get the fonts I downloaded in here installed, but I don't think I did it properly. And I noticed that there's different heights and things here. I'm not quite sure what the ratio would work out to for some of these fonts. I'm sure that's how I would fix it, but anyway, I've opened up the manual, and what I want to see is left clicking on a palette color and empty space. We'll select it, right clicking, select it as background. I'm going to turn on word wrap here. Okay, let's see. Width and height is what I'm looking for. Options, okay. Unlimited font size. Setting this value to 1 loads all fonts, even those which allow extreme zooming where it produces a window that doesn't fit on the screen. Okay. RexPaint.cfg is what I'm looking for. Okay, hold on a second. File, open. RexPaint.cfg. Perfect. Okay, so I've opened my RexPaint file. And I'm also going to just check that real quick to see if perhaps it's not writable. Let's find out. Because it should save that, right? Is my thinking. So looking at the config file, it is not read-only. So I'm not quite sure, but I can change it here. So let me change this to 80 and save this and then go back to RexPaint and then exit it and come back and let's just see if this, okay. So it didn't save, that's fine. And let's open up RexPaint. Okay, that did take. So a manual edit works. It's interesting that I can't do it on its own, but sleepy, XCOM. Autumn. Neat. Okay, so looking at this, you can see that you get different palettes and fonts and things. I want to just kind of show off this program a little bit and learn it also. So the default image width and height, width of the first blank image created on startup that I've newly created. Set to 0 to automatically match the canvas view. Okay. So you can have different widths. That's one thing that's different about this format. The other thing is that there's a great undo history. You get 10,000 steps by default. There's an autosave, blah, blah, blah. I don't think this really matters But this would be if you were programming something that was very palette centric, I guess, for your font or font centric. Message duration, confirm unsaved, scroll rate, number of rows to scroll up and down when wheel scrolling. Okay. Check their version. Okay. All that's whatever. Okay. So this shows or hides the layer. And how do we create a new layer? Just hit the plus button. So now we have layers. This is the other thing that I thought was really cool that Pablo Draw does not have. So if I X this out, I can hide and lock. So just like I would on Photoshop, I don't think I can rename these, but that's okay. So let me choose a palette. In the options, I guess I'll do it. Oops. In the options, I will choose this Arnie 64, which is a great real minimal palette. Okay. So my thinking is, in addition to just using it for text mode, I could use it for building pixel stuff. And this is cool because it's a different way to think about pixel art. And you can save it, I believe, when you do exports, it saves it as a PNG. So let me just try to whip something together here real quick. I'll just put some basic stuff. The other thing I want to mention, this apply section determines what gets painted. So you can see it's painting the background color right now. And if you click on the colors, you can pick one. I don't want to do that right now. I'm going to Control Z for undo. I'm going to just click here to turn off the background. And now when I paint, it should be painting orange. For some reason, it's not. Why? My glyph is on. Oh, I had a blank glyph. Okay. So this is like the single pixel. Okay, I'll just draw like a really quick orange thing. How about a pumpkin, because it's Halloween? And as you guys know, probably from seeing the other content on my channel, I really like a lot. I really like text mode art. And so I'm really keen to see what I can come up with here, just with some basic ideas. So for an example, I never really use these things in ANSI because, and I want the background to be on, right, foreground to be, okay, so I want an orange background. So right click on the orange one and the foreground is black. Okay. So right, so I don't get a chance to use the full character set really inside of ANSI, and it's not anything wrong with ANSI. But I just like to experiment with other things as well in the text domain. Okay, so here's a really lame pumpkin. Also, if you right click, it's kind of like pick up everything in the program so that you're applying. So if you right click here, it's going to pick up a foreground. It's going to have no cell or glyph, and it's going to be a background like that. But if I right click here, now you can see the glyph is picked up. Now I'm pretty sure if I right click and these aren't on apply, let's find out what happens. So now I'm going to turn this off. I'm going to right click here and I think, yeah, my glyph stays the same. So whatever you've got highlighted in your apply is what's going to get picked up with your right click. Okay, so that's cool. That's really cheesy looking. We can also do a better job at at this side of this pumpkin here. Now, here we're limiting ourselves to the same character set that was in ANSI, and so it's actually a little bit more cumbersome because there's no F6, F5 kind of thing, and maybe there is, I don't know yet. But what I find interesting is just my way of thinking about this art is completely different. Like, I'm thinking about it in a way that isn't really the same kind of like thought process. So let me change this up and I'm going to do, instead of that, I'm going to use this big square. And so we're going to do that guy and that guy and that guy. But what it forces you to do is really think about how you're designing things. So, and the other thing that's cool, watch this. So now I have all of this kind of stuff set up. Now if I disable background and glyph, when I draw, it'll paint over everything. So let's undo that. What I want to do is fill. So now I can click in here and you can see there's like a flood fill, which is really neat. That's pretty cool. You can also do rectangles. And in this case, I need the glyph to be also selected, right? And if you fill it, you just click that little button. That's something you can do. You can do ovals, and there's an option to start at the center or not, and you can fill them also. And I think this will maybe create a line style. I don't know. But this, I don't know what that does. Maybe it's like more greedy. Oh, wow. Trippy. I don't know what I've done there. And then obviously you can enter text. This is a neat thing. So when you're drawing menus, lots of times you want to just, you know, if you have one of these little things and you're like, I need a menu. Okay, well, that's cool. But wouldn't it be cool if it could automatically do my menu? Oh, look at that, it can. So when you choose a rect, and let's get rid of fill, and now you're using this, it's smart enough to know, okay, I want that to happen. And it's also smart enough to know what that means. So I don't know, I just think that's cool because you can do a lot of neat little things like that, which is neat and I like it. Right, so what I haven't found is how to erase. I can see copy and paste, but I don't see like cut and stuff like that. I know there's an undo, and I guess you just pick nothing, and you maybe just do like a rectangle filled with it and just drag over it. Okay, that makes sense. And then I can check my fill with four in my glyph and see what's going on there. Okay, so I'm still getting the hang of it. So that was filling with the glyph. Let's just fill it with the foreground. Okay. So anyway, those are the basics of this program. So let's see if we save this guy and we're going to call it pumpkin. Okay. So now if I go to browse, here's my pumpkin Rex file. And I think if I go to export, it's going to put it in my images folder. So let me pull that up real quick and see what that looks like. So Rex, where is that? Let me see. So browse images pumpkin. Okay, so there's nothing there. I don't know what the one means either. Maybe it's just how many images are in there. Let me see if I can find that file inside the config. So base image path is images. Maybe that's so where the heck is that folder? Data. No. So here I've got my double commander set up and I'm inside of my RexPaint directory. This is just where I unzipped it and this is where the config is and the manual and so on. So I would have thought that it would have been here, but it's not. And you can see there's an experiment that I did before. Rex, that's the icon. Yeah, so where would it be? Maybe in my home folder? Let me check that for a minute. No, it's not there. Maybe it's in my documents. Is there a Rex Paint? No. Okay, I don't know where the heck it put those images. Okay, let's check in the manual then. I don't know why it's doing that. It's weird. Okay, anyway, let's check inside Visual Studio's manual.txt and let's look for export. Export.ans, export ping, browsing exporting. Okay, unless you're drawing art for game, you probably want you to share your images elsewhere. Compressed XP use export button. By default, the new file can be found in the images directory. Okay. Exporting to ANSI is also possible. That's cool. Okay. So it says that if we click here, it's going to put it in images pumpkin relative to the exe location. Okay, so let's try save again. Okay, let's do browse real quick. Right click, I can rename it. Okay, that's not helpful. Images with that name already exist, change or cancel. Okay, I can't get into here. So the program is definitely something that is going to require some deeper thought for sure. Export PNG is Control E. Okay. Right. So let me really quickly see. What does resize do? Oh, nice. Let me really quickly see what the heck Okay. Actually, it's a good time to show you the website anyway, so hold on a minute. Here's the website for RexPaint. It's gridsagegames.com/RexPaint. So they have a pretty good forum. Let's check here. And let's look for images, path. Nothing. Okay. Images. An error has occurred. Oh, I gotta wait. It's the flood protect. Okay. Announcement. Migrating to the new version before you high preview resolution font. Depending on your eyesight, the size of your preferred gaming machine screen. Okay, that's for Cogmind. So this guy made this game called Cogmind that uses all of his stuff, which is actually a pretty neat thing that he made. Maybe I'll show that later and buy it to support him. Presuming I can figure this shit out, I just need to figure out where it put the images. So images. So if we look, you can also see some gallery stuff. Let me show you this because this is pretty sweet. Like this guy, Polydux, does a really good job using this program. It's pretty incredible what he's able to create using only these kinds of things. So there's definitely a niche audience. But I'm in that audience. And a buddy of mine at work, we were talking about Dwarf Fortress, and I got to thinking about my text mode roots and how maybe it would be cool if I could create art using text mode and then put it into a game that I make with like Game Maker or something. And so I was thinking about that. Like, look at that, that's beautiful. That's meticulous work too, like how that's difficult. That's pretty sweet too. But yeah, it's inspiring to look at some of this stuff. And it's lo-fi, which is right up my alley. That's interesting. How did they pull that off? Readable proportional ASCII font. Oh, maybe he's just doing it in code or something. Because I haven't seen colored fonts yet. That's cute. Interesting. So yeah, being the nerd that I am and being into text mode, I thought it was cool. This is really cool too. It's the Cthulhu kind of dude. So yeah, there's a lot of inspirational things that I might be able to do if I could figure out how this works. So let me... So if I look at where this program is running from, it's running from that directory. So it's definitely the right spot. I would expect the program to store the files here, but I am not seeing them here. I would have expected them to go here. They are not there. So let's think about this. The other thing that's possible is they could be in a home directory, I suppose. And I guess I can grep for or find pumpkin. That'll at least search my home directory. Is that what I called it? Export images pumpkin.png. I'm thinking that if it can't find, or if it can't save the config, I'm guessing maybe it can't write. So let me try this. I'm going to start this as an admin and just see if that rectifies our issue. Let's see, shall we? Okay, apply, because then we should definitely be able to write. So let's see. Okay, so the config and everything is right. Let's see if we change our config. Let's just change this back to 60. And then we exit. Let's check inside of Visual Studio Code. If it changed, it did not change. What is going on, RexPaint? Okay, let's check something here. Read only. No, right. I wonder if I'm just a silly head and I'm doing this wrong. Okay, I don't care about that. I want to see. So I want to open this in code. So this is the README, which is different than the manual. Okay. RexPaint is Windows only. Okay. Let's turn on WordWrap. Must have write access to its directory. Make sure the program is run with admin rights. Got it. Okay. So that is new information. So let's make sure. That it can write to the things that it needs to write to. Because that would make sense, which would make me feel a lot better about myself and not being an idiot. Okay, let's try this again. Options, 60. Exit. Nope, it did not change it. And I can, Visual Studio Code should have updated. Let me just close this and see maybe if the file handle is open. Reopen closed editor. Yeah, so let's try it again. RexPaint. Options. 60. That's saving an image. Okay, let's hit escape. Maybe it has to do something. I don't know what that is. Exit. Okay, reopen closed editor. No, so it's not writing to the directory. I wonder if it's a OneDrive issue. All right, let me try something real quick off cam. I'm going to move this into my home directory. And I'll just put it. Actually, let me kill this shortcut first. Okay. So I'm going to just put it in my home directory. Just going to move it right now. Okay, RexPaint. And okay, so now if I launch it from my home, first of all, let's check, right click, properties, read only, apply, disable. Okay, right click, properties, read only is still set. All the folders have contents indexed, blah, 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 blah. That is interesting. Oh, wait, I'm a dummy. Do advanced attributes, security. I have full control. What is happening? I am the owner and I have full control. Okay. I do not understand this, but we're going to launch it from here now. And we're going to do so as an admin. Now I'm going to put an option in place. 60. Exit. This file is wrong, so ignore all this. Because it's not even the right place. These files don't exist anymore in a relevant way anyway. What needs to happen is this is the editable one now. Open with code, 6060. Okay, now we're cooking with gas. So I think the fact that OneDrive was in the path, maybe it was hosing it, I don't know. Let me also right click and choose pin to start 10. Which is my favorite thing. And the program isn't running. I'm gonna launch it from here. And I'm gonna change it again and make sure we're good, because it could be start 10 maybe that's posing it. Yeah, maybe it is. Or it could be, yeah, that could be it. Because if I ran it from here as an admin, wait a minute, let me check the start 10 shortcut. If that's not run as admin, maybe it won't work. So let me do this again. And then this, and then this, and then this, and then this, and then this. Nope. So start 10 hates it. That sucks. So let's unpin it from there then, and I guess we'll just launch it this way. Run as admin, options, 80, exit, run as admin. Okay, so yeah, it's start 10 that hated it. Maybe it's the way that it starts the wrong place. Let me see. Pin to start 10, start. And then properties, let's see what its start in program is. Start in is empty. Okay, let's change that to use this folder. And let's change the advanced run as administrator, apply, okay. Let's try this again. Maybe it's as simple as it needs to be told where to start and there's an implicit start in. So let's do this again. Options, 60, exit. That was it. Okay, so it wasn't OneDrive, so that's good. because I don't want to run this from here. I want to run it from my OneDrive. So let me go to my OneDrive, documents, and then drawing, and then RexPaint again. I'm going to unpin this because now I've learned that. Holy cow. And then I'm going to pin to start 10 from there. And then I'm going to modify my shortcut for this. And I want to show you guys this just because I think it's going to help somebody else. So I'm going to copy this path into the start in of my shortcut. Whoops. Here. And I'm going to change it to run as administrator. Click apply and apply. So now when I start it that way from my start 10 shortcut, I should be able to write to this directory. So let's do options 60. Escape, exit, and we should be at 60, and we are. Good. So now I know that what we build is going to save it. So let's also change some of these things because I want to change the default font to, actually 16 by 16 is fine, but I want the palette to be Arnie 64 by default. Also, I downloaded a bunch of other palettes, including some Apple II ones, which I thought would be fun to mess with. Maybe we could create a mouse text font. And do it that way, because PlaySki we could do that with, and that's another thing that I'll be making a video on. But yeah, okay, so I'm gonna do 80, and now I'm going to exit, and I'm gonna launch my shortcut, and we're good now. All right, so now I'm gonna draw my pumpkin. And I'm going to clear the background color, because right now the background color is, I think this is transparent. I think that's why it says dash. Maybe. Like it's not a color at all. Oh, right click here will change the current to add it. Can I just drag it around? I cannot. How do I? Oh, oop, cancel. I'm a noob. I'm sorry, guys. I want to delete that color. How do I do that? D. So foreground and background. I get how that works. Cancel. All right. Whatever. I'm going to pick this. I'm going to get rid of the background. And now when I click the glyph, we'll be able to paint. All right, so I'm just going to do a quick pumpkin. I'm not going to do anything fancy like that. And you can fill like you might think, just like you would in a paint program, which is neat. Which I thought was pretty cool. And if you stay with your foreground and background, you don't have to juggle those as much. But I think as I get a better handle on this program, I'll understand it more. I don't know how to move things or change a block selection. I'm guessing if there's layers, you should be able to move the layers. I guess I'll find that out. Okay, so now let's save our image. We're going to call it pumpkin. Okay, let's see if that exists in our file system. Images, yay, it's there. Okay, cool. So now let's do export, and now we should have a PNG file in there as well. So let's see how big it is. Okay, so this is 100% and 41 by 361. Actually, wait, 12, I think I'm seeing it. Hold on, I'm not seeing it the proper size. I want to do, where the hell, let me open this with another editor. Let me open it with XnView if the program doesn't crash on me. Of course it's going to, because I'm trying to show you something. Sweet, dude. Alright, we'll fix that. We're going to open up another double commanders, and this is all broken. It's all about broken. And we're going to go to RexPaint images, and I'm going to configure this to use my infront view instead, because that's a better image viewer. And also this thing lost its guy friend. So there. Okay. So this is 100%. So 1280 by 960 is the size. So if we look at this, I can't rearrange the window easily because it's an SDL app, but if I put this over, it's an exact size of what I'm seeing. So that is really cool, because now I know that I can do something smaller scale, like a 12 by 12. Actually, there's a 10 by 10, which is probably a safer choice. Let's do, ooh, there's an 8 by 8, but let's do 10 by 10. So now, if I go back, exit, you can see now if I export this, let me make sure it's not open, and it's not. Let's export now, and this should be a smaller size, and it is. Okay, so you get what you get. What you see is what you get, and that's an 800 by 600 because of the 10 by 10 ratio. Because we have 80 by 60, so 80 times 10 across is 800 by 600. That makes total sense to me. Okay, so yeah, that's pretty cool. And I can see how I would have some fun doing really lo-fi artwork this way, and having a good time at it. I can see how that could be fun. Okay, so the other thing is the fonts that I have here, only a few of them seem to work properly. So let's see if we can figure that out. So if we know now that it's the width of the character times the height, now I think we should be able to modify our fonts properly in the config side. Oops, let me open this in VS Code. Because now we can do our math here. So at a resolution of 80 by 60, we do the math. So 12. So if I open up a calculator and I do 12 times 80, we get 960. So all I have to do is the math there. Okay, so let's put the calculator over there. Ooh, sweet, neat Windows. I didn't know that even was a thing that you did. Okay, so that's giant calculator. Let's kill our sidebar. Let's fix all of these up. And let's also make it nicer looking. And let's change spaces. Let's do that again. Okay, didn't work. Convert indentation to spaces. Why did that not work? Spaces for indent using spaces. Convert indentation. Yeah. I don't know why it's not working. This is the right file, right? Yeah. Okay. Is it because maybe Visual Studio Code can't write to it? Hold on. Damn it. Typer. Run as administrator. Why can't I even pick that? That's not a thing that I can do. That's lame. Let's try that, I guess. Apply. My config might be all jacked if I do this, though. Okay, so there's RexPaint. Okay, I am admin now. I can see it's here. That's nice. Okay, so now if I go back here and I edit this with code, I'm admin. Let's see. Nope, it doesn't seem to make any difference. Maybe I need to re-indent now that I've chosen that. Nope, I don't understand why that won't work. I can see that it should work, but it's not working. Convert indentation to spaces. No, it's just like, fuck you. Indent using tabs for convert indentation to tabs. See, it's not doing it. It's not doing what it should. Even this isn't doing it. Okay, screw it. We're going to do it manually. So I'm just going to use tabs, I guess, for now. I'll just line them up that way. Because that'll be sweet. Then we can get our fonts on. You know what I'm saying? And actually, let's do this smarter. I think actually I could have done that with... Okay, it doesn't honor to that delimiter. Weird. Hold on. There we go. But now if I go back one, what the shiz? Ass. Screw it. I'm just going to do it this way. Also, I don't need to launch Visual Studio Code as admin, but I'm going to keep that way anyway. Okay. Okay. Yeah, it's just white space is the delimiter. We could have used spaces, but let's make it prettier. You know what I'm saying, man? I know you do. I know you know what I'm saying. Okay, now this, we're just going to do the math, and we're going to do the same thing and put the comment on the end so that we know what's happening. Wait, set name GUI art available. What does that even mean? Because they're all the same. Whichever is listed first. I guess I'll worry about that in a minute. I'll also make this file available for downloading if I get it right. Because that's a nice guy thing that I can do for the world of the internets. Okay. Why isn't it? Okay. So, resolution at. And, I mean, this looks like a comment, but maybe it's not. Because those all worked. And the ones that worked were accidentally working when I had set it as a multiple of the characters. Width, right? So this is going to be 8 times 8. So that's going to be 640 by 480. This is going to be, so 6 times 8, that's 480 by 600, right? Is that right? Math? Is that a thing that happens? I hate that mini map. Hide the mini. Toggle mini map. There you go. Okay. And I want to badop these guys too. I don't know what GUI means. It might be like the label that it has. You know what I'm saying? Now here, these are lined up. I can just do that. Badop. And I can do badop. And then badop. Badop. Perfect. Okay. Now I can see that this is a comment. Because he's got it here as a comment. So, whichever. So, the resolution at. Okay, so 1. So, let me think about this for a moment. I don't know what that even means. Available. Art. Okay, so here's our GUI name. Here's our art. And here's our available. And then. Here's the resolution. Maybe Maybe it is necessary. I don't know. I don't know. Y'all, whichever is listed first is automatically considered available. Okay. Well, let's just do this anyway. We'll humor ourselves. So this is going to be 12 times. So this is going to be 12. Well, let's make sure I got the other one right. 6 times 80. Yeah, 480. Okay, so 12 times 80 is 960. Stop auto completing. 20 times 60 is 1200. And this guy is going to be 10 by 10, so he's going to be 800 by 600. 8 by 13, he's going to be 8 times 80. That's going to be 640 by 13. I'm not even going to try to do that math. 780. This is 8 by 8, which is going to be 640 by 480. This is 8 by 8, 640 by 480. This is 640 by 480. 640 by 480. Actually, no, 480 by 600, 8 by 10. Is that right? 8 times 80, 480, right? 640, stupid idiot. 640 by 600. This is going to be 800 by 600 because it's times 10. It's going to be 640 by 480 because 8 times 60. Yeah, this is going to be 640 by 16. 16 times 60, 960. Oops, 960. This is 640 by 960 as well. This is 640 by 480. 640 by 480. Actually, yeah. And then 640 by 480. Okay. Let's leave that just in case he's parsing it for some reason. Okay, so now we've got our fonts, what we think is properly configured. I don't know why that's underlined. It thinks it's a link. That's weird. Whatever. These are the same each one. This is just the name of the font inside of the set name. This is the GUI, this is the art. So I don't know what that means. Let's look in the manual. In the manual, let's close this guy out too. Sure, because I think we already saved it. And if we didn't, that's okay. So let's just take a look in the manual. Back, manual. Open with code. Okay, let's look for font. Fonts, glyphs, fonts. Images themselves, not store. Is the same font available in the data fonts? Let's see. Directory, and blah, 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 config. Must not require square glyphs, but both the GUI and art font must use the same dimensions. When creating a custom font, you can replace all blah, blah. Defines the GUI and art font separately. They do not have to use the same font. One supportive feature not used by the included fonts is alpha transparency. Oh, I see. So the GUI font. So the GUI font here. That's badass, actually. I want the GUI font to not be the same as the art font. I want to always use the small GUI font, I think. So let's use this one for all And let's back up our config. Oh, what happened there? Config.xt. Oh my goodness. Dot back. Dot text dot back dot text. Yes. Yes. Okay. Okay. So now I want this everywhere. Right. So let's do that. Okay, cool. Saving. And that's wrong. What the hell? Oh. This is left over. That's good. Okay. That looks good now. Let's try it now. Please don't crash or kill my computer. Okay. So my font doesn't, that didn't seem to work at all because it's still changing 10 by 10. So maybe I have this wrong. GUI and art. You see how it's resizing the GUI? Let's read the manual again. When creating a custom font, you could even, though you should leave the GUI font unchanged so the interface appears as expected. Defines the GUI and art font separately. They do not have to use the same font. Did it not read them? What's going on? Art versus GUI. Art is what? Degree equal, blah, 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 RexPaint, automatically detect, blah, 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 font key color override, background color, glyphs, select a glyph to draw, glyph swapping, control, left mouse font, not the same glyph. Ooh, neat. Replace every occurrence of a glyph on a visible control left mouse button. That's neat. Okay. I don't understand. Control page up and page down. Okay, there's CP. 14 by 14, 16 by 16, 18 by 18, 8 by 8, 10 by 10. Now, it actually does look the GUI. Does it? No, it's changing everything. Okay, maybe I have it backwards. Let's just make sure. Data, fonts. Stupid idiot. Ten, ten ping. Okay. Let's just make sure that this is the right file. Okay. Available means one or zero. Okay. So 10 by 10 by 10 didn't seem to make any difference. I've also noticed that it didn't use tabs to insert that. It's using spaces. Let's do tabs. Ass. I don't think that's going to make any difference. Okay, so and the default didn't have any quotes, but I guess I could add quotes and see if that factors. Let's not do it here. Let's see if that matters. And I wonder, wait, that's the ping file, underscore 10. Okay, so that's the dot ping. Okay. I think I broke in my program. It hates it. It doesn't like the quotes. So let's get rid of those quotes, shall we? Now the program won't even fucking start. That's groovy. Great job, Rick. Or maybe it's already running in the background. Let's see. No, it's not. It's freaking broke. I broke it. Okay, let's change this to old broke. And we will change this to .txt, and hopefully it starts. It's not even starting anymore. Awesome. Awesome, dude. Stop. Stop stopping. R-E-X. I do not know how, but I broke it. I broke the crap out of it. Let's try launching it from this here. Yeah, it's crashing like shiz. Crash log. What's the problem? Load fonts. Unable to open config file. It doesn't have a lock on it, does it? That's a nice feature that it has that crash log. Maybe it has a lock on it? Nope. Data fonts underscore config.xt. Oh, XT is the freaking name of the font, you dummy. You're an idiot. You're a stupid ass. .xt was intentional. Data fonts. So this is actually XT. And now let's try it. RexPaint. No. Crashlog. RexPaint. Okay, so now it might be the quotes though. So there's no quotes. Shazbot. Underscore config.xt. All right, let's try this again. Okay, it's blipping, so it's still crashing. Open with code. Data fonts config.xt. I see that here. Right? I'm not tripping, am I? And it should be owned and all that good stuff because I'm launching it as an administrator. Data fonts. Config.xt properties. It's not read only. I broke it. All right, this is what I'm going to do. Old that. Let's see. Okay, we rescued it. So that's good. Let's compare these files. What in the heck is going on with those things? Let's open with code. And let's open with code. And let's compare these. Well, it's not a very good comparison at all, is it? Except the GUI one here doesn't match the art. Fonts do not require square glyphs. Both the GUI and art font must use the same dimensions. Okay. So that's why. So when creating a custom font, you can even... Okay, wait a minute. I think I can. So for 8x8, I can use this one, right? That makes sense to me. And for 6x10, I don't have one, so that's fine. 12x20, I don't have one. 10x10, I have one. So let's do that. And 8x13, I don't have one. 8x8, I have one. Here. And 8x8, and 8x8, and 8x8. Okay. I think we're cooking with gas now. 8x10, I don't have one, but I have an 8x8 and a 10x10. Okay, here's a 10x10, and here's an 8x8. Let's see if there's any other. Okay, so 8x8. I do not have an 8x16. I don't even like that one anyway. Let's get rid of that one. Here's an 8x8. So, ba-dup. Ba-dup. And ba-dup. And ba-dup. And ba-dup, ba-dup, and ba-dup, ba-dup. Okay, so all those 8x8s and 10x10s should translate no problem in this. Galaxija, I'll get rid of. Teletext, I'll get rid of for now. You know what? I'll just make it unavailable. Okay, let's save that after we quit the program, make sure. Okay, saving, opening. Okay, so we are using, what font are we using? Drake 10x10, let's check one. So cubic feet, we change that. Sam Coop, yes, it's working. I can see that as I change the font now, the GUI is okay. You see how it's using the same GUI font? And it's actually legible now. So that's good. Okay, that's awesome. Perfect. Perfect. Okay, so now let's check this Hitachi one. Okay, don't care about that really. But I do care about that 10x10. That's the one I want it to be by default. And what's the difference between Drake 10x10? And let's just take a look. Let's kill, so let's just get rid of him. Let's pick him, let's do this, and let's just ba-dip. Okay, so that's that guy. And then Drake, that's Drake. And then what is our regular 10x10? CP, escape, it looks the same to me. Let's take a screenshot. Actually, we can just look at the image inside of here. So let's do 10x10 here, and then Drake 10x10 here. And looking at them, what is the difference? I see. The dots are those, is one difference. Ooh, I actually like Drake because the font is cooler. This is more of a terminal font. Okay. Okay, cool. And actually, I kind of like Drake's 10x10 for all the 10x10 fonts, but for now I'll leave it. Okay. So yeah, things. So now let's pick this and let's do control click. What did they say? Control right click, control click, control click, shift click, choose replacement glyph. Oh wait, okay, so shift here, swap zero occurrences. Okay, so we're going to shift, choose, we're going to replace that with this. What the hell did I just do? Undo. Okay, click that. The swap canceled. Okay. I don't know what's happening. I want to place this with that. Oh, there we go. Swap 19 occurrences, so now we'll pick this, choose replacement glyph. That, okay, so you have to hold shift the whole time. You have to keep shift held. So if I want to replace that With that, I can do that. That's pretty cool. And that's not going to work because it's doing a find and replace like thing. Okay, cool. All right. So that is pretty nifty. So now how do we select? Let's check the manual again. Okay. Glyph swapping, selection and editing, left clicking on a palette. We'll select it. Shift clicking will also open, but once new color is confirmed, we'll replace all matching colors in the image. Okay, cool. So they're just slots. Got it. The color picker is fairly straightforward, blah, blah, blah. How do we control shift E? We'll create a new empty palette, then add it to all unique. Nice. Now how do we select? So we have layers, control, order, visibility, merging. Toggle extended layers on a show cover and info window. A star appears at the top left if an image contains more layers than what is currently listed. Okay. How do you move things around in the editor? Draw modes, oval, alternate mode, control X, fill. Maybe you can't. Shifting. To view different parts of a large image, hold spacebar while left-clicking on the image and move the mouse to drag it. Okay, that's like Photoshop. Okay. Nice. Okay. Numpad can also be used for eight-directional. Enter resets its location. Control-Enter. So, da-ba-da-ba-da. Enter. Control-Enter. Control-Enter. Okay, it's the other Enter. Resize, black. So it doesn't look like you can move things like with a selection. Let's look at layers again. Able to manipulate the palette itself. Okay, palette swapping, color shifting, transparency layers. Control L or plus. Okay, deletion is not possible if there's only one layer. The active layer is the one which effects are applied to when drawing the image. Okay. Or using the mouse wheel cursor is over the canvas area. Okay, so let's create some and just ba-da, ba-da, ba-da. Okay, that's cool. Ba-da, ba-da. And this just moves it, I presume. Yeah. Okay, ba-da. And ba-da. Okay. Layers are listed in the top, bottom, top to bottom. The higher layers will obscure the lower layers. Got it. Visibility. Yeah. Merging. Use the shift to merge layer downward. Extended layer mode. To view more than that, hit E. Okay. Ba-da, 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 ba-da. E. Ba-da, 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 ba-da. Okay, so it can only go up to a maximum of 9. Are undo part of the layer stacks? They are. Okay, and then get rid of that. Back to that. Okay, so an asterisk appears if there's more than one layer. So I'm on the only layer I can be on. Browsing, file image control, exporting options. Okay, so I'm thinking that there isn't any way to create a selection and move it, but I would have to believe, wait, shift selection. Okay, that's for font, palette, drawing. Let's look here. Line, toggle, oval, drawing method, fill, copy, paste, cut. Would be the way, and then paste, so control X. But how do I do that? Text tool. Alt, highlight, hovered color, and current layer. Set, swap, extract, edit, and replace. Okay. Swap foreground and background, Alt W, that's nice to have. Canvas, shift wheel, scroll image up and down, center, copy cell contents, applied modes only, enter drag mode, hold canvas to drag, shift and alt, hold to hide the preview, shift and alt, oh, I see, so alt and I don't see at all, apply color shift, apply swap, copy entire active layer to the clipboard. Toggle rect dimension display. drawing selecting a rectangle. Also use also the RDIM. Okay, maybe that's the selector. I don't know what that is. RDIM. Rect dimension. I don't know what that does. So foreground, that's changing. What the hell does RDIM do? Toggle grid resolution, switch between current and previous image, control L, layer height lock, extended layers, edit value. General. Okay, so I'm thinking maybe if we just do rect and we don't apply anything, and we, or maybe we just do this, maybe we do copy, that's how we do it, and then paste, copy, copy. Oh, you know what? I gotta have things that I'm copying, you dumbass. Copy, paste. Okay, sweet. Can I flip? That would be handy. Oh, and it looks like it's a brush. That is nice. And then when I'm done, what do I do here? Hit escape. I just draw. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, cool. So we're starting to get the hang of this. Can you flip? Flip by position, paste flip ASCII. Control V, paste the clipboard. Alternate modes, flip clipboard contents vertically or both. By default, this automatically converts non-symmetrical. Control V, Control X, cut mode, okay, paste clipboard, alternate modes, flip clipboard contents. What is the alternate mode? How do I, oh, Control V times twice, nice. That's a nice feature. Is it only horizontal? Probably. So let's do new, get rid of the background. Let's do a glyph, derp. And let's do copy, paste. Oh no, it rotates it. Bad asses. And it looks like it's smart enough to only paste what's needed to paste. And then when I'm done, pick cell. Ba-derp. Ba-derp. Sweet, dude. That's sweet. So now if I hold shift and I click, I want to replace that. Actually, I want to shift click this and replace that. And that. Swap zero occurrences. Okay, shift click this. The replacement glyph is that. Nice. And undo, that works also. Okay, cool. I am getting the hang of this. And you can draw lines, which is nice because it's much easier to do that. And then you can draw ovals like I showed you. And then you can type as well. Typing things. And I think this is just, after this, you could just do your regular old stuff here. And it looks like you just do a columnar-based one. And that's cut. So control X. So X and C, X, control C. I see that toggles between those. So control V and then control V again. And it's rotating it. That's tight. Okay, good. And I can say typing things all over the place. Okay. Getting the hang of this. Okay. So now, what the hell is RDIM? Toggle rect dimension display. Direct. Rect. Applies the fact to a rectangular. Rect. and release the button at the opposite corner. Right button, escape before releasing the button. Okay, alternate fills the entire rectangle, so drawing the outline, non-filled. Okay, back rect mode, but draws ovals. Fill search is performed in 8 direction rather than 4. Interesting. Copy rectangular. Rect, 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 rect. Directly, directly. Fill 8 direction. Toggle rect dimension. Maybe I should look for dimension. Even smaller. Change. Okay. Toggle rect dimension display for drawing selecting a rectangle. Maybe when it's okay. Let's turn this on. And let's. It says for drawing and selecting a rectangle. Oh, I see. It's that thing. Maybe. No, I don't see. It's this again. So when that's on. Oh, I see. It adds it right there on the side. So if I turn that off, now it's not there. Okay, cool. Another cool thing is this Shift P thing. So this is the HSV. Let's find Shift P. Control Shift P purge. Hold on. Shift P. Control Shift P. SHFP. What is that? Shift P. Toggle glyph. So solo those things, edit the color. Canvas. Control G, toggle grid. Copy cells. Current layer, uppermost visible. Layer, activate 1 through 4. Edit value, accept new color. I don't know what that is. Shift P, Shift H, and Shift S, Shift V, and Shift P. Okay, I think this has to do with colors. So let's pick the default palette, which is, I guess, palette. Yeah. Okay. And let's toggle those off. And then I'm going to pick this color and shift. Actually, let's do that and cancel. Hold on. So let's grab this. I want to copy that. Oh, fuck. Let's just see. So this is 217.0.217. And this, I want to be 217.0. Oh, I need to hit enter. 217, enter. Okay. And I want to go up by one, like there. Okay. Now I get that palette kind of reacting the right way. Now, to change the color, or to change, organize, extract, purge, set, highlight, hovered color, and current layer. Alt. It's not in there. Let's see if I change this to my other palette here. That's nice. That's really cool. Okay. Edit and replace. Extract image, organize palette, swap palette colors. Source to target. Select color. What is CMB? Control middle button or something? Center bus button, I bet. Okay. Swap is control left mouse button times 2. So if I do this, and then I do double click. What the heck? I hit shift like an idiot. That and that. So control left mouse button times 2. That's not working. And this is within the palette. could do that. The hell am I doing? I have no idea what I'm doing. All right, let's ignore that. I just want to see how to move the color palettes, swap palette, edit and replace, swap occurrence, set. So left mouse button. Okay, so left mouse button is to set, the other one is to edit. Okay, slash changes the palette, it says. It's not working at all. Slash does not change the palette, unless maybe when you double click here, slash. Gosh, I don't know. I don't know. Alt hold. Okay. Move caret left. Insert character anywhere in text. Text tool. Apply GFB. Alt W. That's what I was trying to do. Alt W. There we go. Okay, so that's swap in foreground and background. So if I do this for the foreground and this for the background, Alt W. Cool. That's a handy one. Okay, toggle foreground color channel application. Toggle background color application and Alt Tools, Shift, Control Shift Alt, RGB. Interesting. Okay, Shift all layers in indicated direction. And that wraps. Okay, so that's how you move layers. It's control and nudge and then shift. So that doesn't do anything. So shift control, arrow shift active layer in indicated direction. Oh, I see. Shift alt and hold. Control right mouse button. Shift left, apply color shift to foreground. Shift left mouse button. Oh, I see. It's going through. Nice. So that's how you do it then. And then, so apply shift to foreground. Shift right mouse button. Right mouse button and left mouse button. So that's how you do a color shift. Interesting. So what does this do? It's shifting the saturation. No? What is S? It's shifting. Okay, so shift V. Okay, so that goes with value, right? What is V? It's only going up once. P, that's palette. Okay, H is hue. Yeah, H is hue. And S has got to be saturation. Yep. And then after it's saturated, it can't get any more saturated. Yep, that's what that is. Okay. So when you hold shift and you left click, does that work in this too? No. Shift P. Let's try H. Hold down shift. Okay. So that does not work with other tools, it looks like. It looks like it's only going to work on a single click. Or maybe if I do a selection as I'm holding shift. No. Doesn't matter. Okay. Interesting. Also, we have a grid, which is nice. I don't think you can snap to it or anything because it's already pretty finite. Okay. S saves a color, I think, right? So if I pick this, and I go down here and swap zero occurrences. That's not what I want. Okay, so if I do shift blue, nice. And I go here and swap it back. Swap zero. Oop, cancel. I had the wrong color picked. Okay, so click shift and then shift. Okay, so that's a way to remap colors. That's nice. Okay, how do I create a new one? Just right click, control right click, shift right click. Swapped. Okay, I don't know how to create them. I think I just hit plus. So if I do this and I do the change of the color, it's going to change it. I'm going to do plus first. Oh, plus creates a whole palette. Dummy. Okay, that's not what I want. What does S do? Okay, that saves the palette. That cycles the palette. Okay, so how do you picker palette set foreground, set background? I guess I would just double click on a blank spot and pick my color that way. That makes sense. So now the color is there and I can't move them, right? I can't. Oh no, I can. If I want this guy up here, I can just control click. Okay, cool. Very nice. I'm starting to get the hang of this. Now let's create a new layer. And we're currently on number 2. So if I draw something on top here, okay, and now I can move this layer with control and shift. That is really cool. That is really cool. And I can use my arrows to change that. And control and arrows, shift everything, and shift and arrows and control and change that. What does alt and arrows do? Nothing. Okay, and this wraps also. Okay, cool. Fill 8 direction. Copy, paste, flip. Oh, I see, it's giving you hints. So if you do it twice, control V twice, it's gonna flip. If you double click with your right mouse button twice, it'll edit the color. So if I go here and I double right click, it's going to let me edit it, and I'll change it to this. And it did. Okay. Oops. How do I get help? Is it just question mark? Yeah, question mark on the keyboard will get you help. Control page up changes the font. Arrows shift your selection. Okay. Sell auto walls to 2x does auto walls. Okay, so that's the thing on the side. L is line, R, cut, copy, paste, toggle, solo. So GFB, so G is only going to let me do color now. So if I go back to this layer and draw, oh, that's trippy. Why is it? Because the background. Trippy. I do that now. It's already that color. Yeah, that is cool. So now if I change the background to like this color and I turn that on and turn this off, or just use F and turn B on, now when I drag, it's only going to do the backgrounds. Why did it make it yellow there? That is weird. I'm only doing the background. Huh. I don't know. Can I hide this? What about that? So, hide, down, up, X. Interesting. Okay. Question mark again. Left mouse button, edit color on apply. Okay. So the left mouse button on apply edits the color. So it's saying on these things, it edits the color. So for the glyph, there's nothing I can do for that. That picks up here. Okay. Enter drag mode. Okay, and then control enter to center. Hold canvas to drag. Okay, it's telling you how to drag. Numpad is shift canvas. Copy cell contents for the current layer. Uppermost visible. Okay, so if you right click, cell is actually a text character. So right click is copy cell contents of whatever is toggled. And control and right mouse button is going to get the topmost layer. Undo and redo, toggle grid, new layer. Okay, 1 through 4 and control 1 through 4. Okay, so let's create a new layer. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Control 2, control 2. Okay, makes sense. Picker, edit value, accept new color, shift left mouse button is the folder, new image in folder. So it's going to let you create a folder. Oh, it just lets you create a new image. Okay. Resize, save, export, ping, toggle paint browse, and F3 is options. Okay, so let's try to resize. Let's do 40. Okay, all it does is change the canvas. Got it. And if is this destructive? I'm going to guess yes. Yep, it is. Okay. Interesting. Very interesting. So I think I have a good grasp of this tool now. And this has been a long video, but it's been helpful. So I'm going to just post it as is without editing. And if you like it, you like it. If you don't, you don't. But yeah. So this is RexPaint. And we'll do some cool things with this, hopefully. I'd like to create my own font even. You know what? Why don't we really quickly just try that? Let's create our own font real quick and just see how easy that's done. So I'm just gonna go ahead and clone Drake. I'll copy him, and I'm gonna call it Grim 10x10 ping, and I'm gonna open this inside of Affinity Photo. If it will let me. Of course, it's going to crash. So never mind on that. I'll do it the manual way. And Double Commander can go to hell and die. Except I must have not done that. I must not have loaded this since the new version.
Okay.
Yeah. Sorry, it's kind of late. Okay, so we're going to open. We're going to open our RexPaint font, the drawing directory, and data fonts, and we're going to find the Grim one. Open this guy up. All right, cool. All I'm going to do is try to do one edit, and I'm going to change this to be a little face. So I'm inside of my editor here, and I'm just going to pick my pencil tool, if I can find it. That's the brush. Here we go. Okay, so I'm just going to pick black, and I'm just going to make a little face here on this character. All right, that's cool enough for me. I'm going to save that. File, save. And I'm going to close this guy out. And then I'm going to open my font config. And I'm going to add my font. So it's Grim underscore 10 by 10. CP437 10 by 10. Grim 10 by 10. 1. This is going to be 800 by 600. Control S. Let's see if we can pick our font. That would be pretty nifty. So if we go options here. And here I am. This is me. And hey, look, there's my little face. So I can draw with these guys. That is really neat. I am definitely going to use this a lot, and it's going to be awesome, and I'm happy about that. So, yeah, thank you for watching. If you like this video, please leave a like. If you want, subscribe. I apologize it took so long, but I do feel there was a valuable lesson learned. So thanks. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.